Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in previous videos, I talked about various ways of writing complex numbers. You've got the Cartesian form, the polar trig form, and the polar exponential form. And in this presentation, I'm going to show you how to take powers of complex numbers using this polar exponential form. And the big plus in using this form is that it saves time, and it shows you a little bit about the geometry of taking powers and things like this. So let me share my screen with you, and we can get underway. Okay, so this is the example that we're going to look at. I've got a complex number, z, defined by this polar exponential form. You've got a length to the origin, 2, and an angle to the positive real axis, which is the 5 pi on 6. And we're asked to compute these, you know, z squared, 1 on z, or z to the power, negative 1, and the imaginary part of z. Sometimes write im of z. And we're asked to plot z squared, 1 on z, on the same complex plane. So let me just refresh our memory on different polar forms. Okay, so basically you've got a point in the complex plane. That point has a distance to the origin and an angle to the positive real axis. As you rotate anti-clockwise, the theta increases, and if you go the other way, theta decreases, and theta is zero along the positive real axis. So that is known as the polar trig form. And there's also the polar exponential form, which is the form that we were given today. So you've got r e to the I theta, and you basically the theta and the r are the same, and you can link these two forms via Euler's formula. Okay, all right. So let's work on this and see how we go. All right. So in here, we see that z is in this polar exponential form, r e to the I theta, with r equals 2, and theta, or arg z as we write it sometimes, is 5 pi on 6. Now, note here I've written the argument of z with a capital A, because 5 pi on 6 is between negative pi and pi. Now, some books use 0 to 2 pi. I'm going to use negative pi to pi. So this is in a sort of already in an appropriately simplified form. Okay, so let's compute z squared. Now, to do this, we just use our index laws or power laws. So z squared is just 2e to the 5 pi I on 6, all squared. So let's distribute this squared. It'll be 2 squared, which is just 4, times e to the 2 times all of this. So that'll be 10 pi I all over 6. Okay? Now, this really isn't in appropriately simplified form, which we'd like to do that. Well, we can first of all try to get this coefficient of I up here down to below between negative pi and pi. Okay, so the first thing you do is divide, and you'll get, say, e to the 5 pi I on 3. And then, okay, well, this is certainly between 0 and 2 pi. So let's, you know, sometimes it's easy just to draw a little diagram. So if I go around from the origin, from the positive real axis, if I rotate 5 pi on 3 radians in the anti-clockwise direction, it'll take me over here. Okay, and this angle here will be pi on 3, or radians, or 60 degrees. Okay, so because I start here and I go in a clockwise direction, the argument of this would be negative pi on 3. So this is what this would reduce down to, okay? All right, well, what about 1 on z? Well, that's just like a power of z to the negative 1. So let's keep the same sort of ideas here, just put a negative 1 here. Okay, so distribute that again, you're going to get 2 to the negative 1, which is 1 half. And that negative 1 is just going to act on this, and it's going to be negative 5 pi I on 6. Okay, so for this one, okay, the argument is going to be that what's known as the principal argument, because negative 5 pi on 6 is between negative pi and pi. And if I draw a quick little sketch, we're going to start here and rotate, because it's negative, rotate in the clockwise direction, 5 pi on 6 units. So I'm going to go sort of around to about here. Okay. All right. Okay, so the last thing we want to do is compute the imaginary part of z. So how do I do that? Well, the imaginary part of z is just the imaginary part of this thing here. Now, how do I work out what the imaginary part of that is? Well, I can use this polar trig form over here. Okay, I already know what theta is and I know what r is. So I can write this as the imaginary part of 2 bracket cos of this angle plus I sine of this angle. Okay, now we only want the imaginary part, so this will disappear. So, and we would want to choose the coefficient of I basically with this 2. So it's just 2 times sine of 5 pi on 6. Okay, so again, let's draw a little diagram. You go around 5 pi on 6 radians. Okay, it probably should be a bit lower here. And if you want to, you can even draw in a little triangle. So you compute the, you work with this little angle first. So that's going to be pi on 6. It's going to be a right angle. This will be pi on 3. This will be 2, 1, and root 3. So sine of pi of 5 pi on 6 is going to be negative. Oh, sorry. 1/2, okay? So because if you work out the sine of pi on 6, that's opposite over hypotenuse, and you know that cos is sines are positive here. So CAST, cos, all sine and 10. So this is just 2 times 1/2, which equals 1. Okay? All right, so let's have a look at what we've got. Here's z squared, here's 1 on z, and here is the imaginary part of z. Okay, and so the final thing we're asked to do is plot z, z squared, and 1 on z on the same complex plane. Now, these are little sketches here. They're not very precise, but let's see how we would precisely draw this. Well, for this one, for z squared, we would go out 4 units and rotate pi on 3 radians in the clockwise direction. For this one, we'd go out from the origin 1/2 units and we'd rotate 5 pi on 6 in the clockwise direction. And for plain old z, we would go out 2 units and rotate 5 pi on 6 in the clockwise direction. So let's do those. Here's one that I've sort of started earlier. Okay, so if I was to, say, plot z equals e to the 5 pi on 6, you would rotate 5 pi on 6 in the anti-clockwise direction and go out 2. So that would be your point of z there. What about z squared? Go out 4 and rotate negative, rotate pi on 3 in the clockwise direction. So we would go down here and out 4 units. Okay, so that's going to be z squared. And 1 on z, 1 half unit out, and negative, and 5 pi on 6 in the anti-clockwise direction. So that's going to go out here, and it's going to only be 1 half unit from the origin. Oops. Okay, so that is a sketch of those 3 points on the same complex plane. And you can see what's happening just with the calculations, the sort of geometry of the problem. When you take this number here and you take it to, say, the power 2, you're squaring the length and you're doubling the angle associated with it. Okay, so if you were to, say, measure this angle here, and then keep going and measure all around here, this angle would be half of the whole angle here, okay? Or this angle would be double that angle. So that's one way of giving some geometry into these calculations. You can hopefully see that because I've got using a polar exponential form here, the calculations are pretty easy. But with the geometry, it gives you a nice way of sort of visualizing what should happen. Okay, so when you, for example, take a square, you square the lengths and you double the angles. If it was a cubic here, you would take 2 to the power 3 and you would triple the angle associated with it, and then you simplify. Okay, so that's my presentation, some basic calculations using this polar exponential form. In forthcoming videos, I'll talk more about the polar exponential form and many more examples. So I hope you can join me for those presentations. If you have any feedback, any comments, you can put them in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. Bye.